The Lord does not do anything without leaving witnesses, and God's blessings are such that they cannot be hidden. When God decides to bless your life, He will not just bless you, but will also do it in the presence of your enemies. They will be there to see you rising, and they will marvel at the glory of the Lord shining around you. According to Psalms chapter 23, verse 5, God will prepare a table before you right in the presence of your enemies, and He will cause your cup to overflow. Those are the blessings that cannot be ignored. All those that have tried to bring you down will watch as God will raise you up. Those that have mocked you in the past will be among those that will come to join you in celebrating. Those that have gossiped about you will be the ones spreading the good news of God's greatness in your life. You do not have to look in their direction. Just keep on serving God and showing love to everyone around you, even these enemies. By so doing, you are heaping hot coals on their head. More importantly, your Heavenly Father is watching and seeing all they are doing against you. He's not asleep and knows just how and when He would arise. Do not let them get to you, no matter what. All their mocking, gossiping, and evil plans will soon be brought to an abrupt stop, and instead of seeing you run bankrupt or become hopeless, they will watch God do great and wonderful things in your life. Your blessings are on the way, and the mouths of your enemies will be stopped. Your rising will come as a surprise to them, and they will have no choice but to stand with their mouths opened in great wonder and awe. Just wait for it. God can decide to bless you anywhere you happen to find yourself. Location is not a barrier to Him, but then, He will decide to do it right in the presence of the very people who have opposed you and plotted your downfall. God knows how to take the best revenge for all those things that your enemies have done. He would not suddenly take them out, even though He has the power to do so. Instead, He will preserve them so they can watch things turn around in your favor. Every time they try to bring you down, they will only see you rising. And the beautiful thing is that they will be powerless against what God is doing in your life, and eventually have no choice but to succumb. God will go as far as even using those enemies to announce your glory. He will use them to bring you to that place of honor and glory that He has in mind for you, and they will be unable to resist the force leading them. In most cases, they might not even know that they are helping you get to your greatness. What revenge could be better than that? So let them do their worst. Let them lie about that case. Let them try to run down your business. Let them say evil behind your back. Let them taunt you over and over. God is planning something great for you, and that should be your focus. Do not look at their evil ways and plans and become distraught. Do not give in to despair because of all that is happening now. But even in this period, God is with you. Look forward to the feast that will soon be set before you. Look forward to the joy that is ahead. Let that hope keep you during your moments of distress and those periods where it looks as if the enemy is winning. But be rest assured that they cannot win. God is coming in with a great surprise. Your blessings will come in multiple folds so great that the enemy will become frustrated. They will not be able to fathom what is happening despite all their evil thoughts and plans. As they try to destroy you, you will only become stronger. Every one of their plans will turn against them, and they will regret ever going against you to begin with. People will just rise up from nowhere and come against you even when you have done nothing to deserve their enmity. They might just hate your simplicity or diligence or your lifestyle in general. Daniel excelled in the land of Babylon and remained dedicated to praying to God even in a strange land. As a result, the other princes became envious of him and planned to bring him down. But what happened? First, they watched God deliver and vindicate him, and then they were taken out of the scene. You might be experiencing similar things at work, There might be someone that does not like your diligence or lifestyle of holiness, or maybe a neighbor detests you for praying all the time. Your colleagues at work may be envious of the favor you get from your boss and just wish to get you out of the picture. As a result, you might begin to experience one form of difficulty or the other. For instance, someone might tell a lie to make you lose your job, connive with others around and taunt you endlessly, or do many other things just to get at you. The best response is to keep on doing good. The Bible says that as much as it is within you, live peacefully with all men. Do not let anybody's anger or envy stop you from being the child of God that you are. If you succumb, then they would have achieved their goal. Instead, stand your ground and put your trust in God. He will not only deliver you from those problems, He will promote you and bless you in addition, and your enemies will be there to witness it. Joseph's brothers turned against him and sold him to slavery. They thought that was the end of the road for him, until a famine came upon the land, and they had to go to the land of Egypt. And it was no other than Joseph himself that was in charge of the food they were going to get. They bowed before him without knowing, and even when they knew, they still bowed before him because he had risen to a level where he can determine their lives and future. God is also taking you to that height and realm where your enemies will bow to you. Those that have facilitated your removal from work will come searching for employment at your doorsteps. Those that have put you down and wished you bad will watch you rise to the top. Potiphar's wife would never have imagined that Joseph would one day rule over her, but that was exactly what happened, and her wicked act made it come to reality. You are moving from obscurity into limelight, from being a nobody to becoming someone great. God is stepping you up in every area of your life, giving answers to every one of your prayers and raining His blessings in abundance upon you. Your enemies will watch and be confounded. They will be put to shame and their mouths will be shut for lack of words. Their efforts over your life will become frustrated and eventually, they will give up. Just take your stand for God and keep looking up. Those questioning you now and asking to see your God will begin to see His works in your life. You may have been barren for a long time, hoping to have a child of your own, and tongues are wagging against you. People are laughing and saying all kinds of wicked things behind you or even in your presence. Do not be discouraged. Your children are coming. Just as God answered Hannah, He will also answer you and bless you with the fruit of the womb. You might be in search of a life partner, but no one seems to be forthcoming, and it looks as though time is not on your side anymore. God is preparing the best person for you. You might have lost your job through a plot against you, but that should not deter you in any way. God has greater plans for you, and the things He will do in your life will shock the enemy. If Haman had known that his hatred for Mordecai would lead to his end, he never would have gone against him at all. First, God used him to announce Mordecai around the city. It was very humiliating for him, but instead of desisting and taking that as a warning, he went ahead to plan his death, which only boomeranged in his face. That is exactly what happens when you let God do the fighting for you. He will uplift you and frustrate the thoughts and plans of your enemies. Just as the Bible says, their plans will not stand, neither will it come to pass. When they expect you to be down and defeated, they will watch you standing strong and glowing in the glory of God. They will be there to witness as God takes you from one level of glory to another, blessing you in all ramifications. Your finances will rise, and all those that have planned to make you bankrupt will be the one begging your favor. Just relax and enjoy the feast that God is preparing for you right in the presence of your enemies. You have nothing to worry or fear.